May the faithful find salvation, and careless be awakened. Here may the doubting find faith, and the anxious be encouraged. Here may the tempted find help, and the sorrowful find comfort. Here may the weary find rest, and the strong be renewed. Here may the young and old find consolation and inspiration, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We confess our sins because God commands and calls us to be honest with ourselves and with each other. Because we need a reminder that we are all in the same boat, because confession helps us to recognize our brokenness. But here's the great news that we all need to be reminded of. We mess up. God loves us anyways. We ignore our faith. Jesus invites us into our relationship. We confess, and through Christ, we are forgiven. Amen. You've heard the great news about being forgiven. So now show what that means to you. Share the peace of Christ that gives you. Pass the peace to those surrounding you. Because immeasurable love is not something we keep to ourselves. May the peace of Christ be with you all.
Thank you. All right, I'd like the children to come forward, please, if you join me on the front steps. Come on up. How are you all today? Good. Well, today we are going to be recognizing our high school seniors, these four people right up here behind you. And there's Michael, there's Francesca, Samuel, and Kaylee up there. And so today, our gospel lesson that we're going to hear in a few minutes is about Jesus praying for his disciples. So what we want to do today is pray for our seniors up here. And so before we do that, I would like for you all to help me out with something. Can I get four volunteers? Okay. It's really easy. You don't have to say anything. I promise. Grab that. I need two more. All right. Thank you. Now, what I'd like for you all to do, and everybody, I'd like for everybody to come up here. Here. Seniors, if you all would kind of stand up and just stand right here. I want you all to go up and give them a hug and tell them that you will be praying for them. And don't look at me like that, Nate. And I'd like for you to give them these books. These are Bible dictionaries that we are giving to our seniors this year, so you can have those with you to when you are studying your Bible. Of course, you'll be doing that a lot, I'm sure. Yes, you will. And so I'd like for you all to go up there and give those to our seniors and just say, we'll be praying for you, and give them a hug or shake their hand, whatever you're comfortable with, okay? So I'll start us off up here. We'll be praying for you.
Thank you.
Will y'all pray for me, with me rather, and pray for me too. That would be good, yeah. I didn't know that would be that funny. So just repeat after me. Loving God, we pray today for our graduating seniors. Please let them know that your love will be with them. Even when they're away from the church, as they go, move on to their college lives. And all these things we pray through Jesus. Amen. Thank you all. Y'all can have a seat.
Loving God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our reading today is from Psalm 97, a hymn of praise celebrating the rule of God. The Lord is King. Let the earth rejoice. Let the many coastlands be glad. Clouds and thick darkness are all around him. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of his throne. Fire goes before him and consumes his adversaries on every side. His lightnings light up the world. The earth sees and trembles. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord of all the earth. The heavens proclaim his righteousness, and all the peoples behold his glory. All worshippers of images are put to shame. Those who make their boast in worthless idols, all gods bow down before him. Zion hears and is glad, and the towns of Judah rejoice, because of your judgments, O God. For you, O Lord, are most high over all the earth. You are exalted far above all gods. The Lord loves those who hate evil. He guards the lives of his faithful. He rescues them from the hand of the wicked. Light dawns for the righteous, and joy for the upright in heart. Rejoice in the Lord, O you righteous, and give thanks to his holy name. Gospel reading. Today's gospel reading is from John 17, 20 through 26. Jesus prays for his disciples. I ask not only on behalf of these, but also on behalf of those who will believe in me through their word, that they may all be one. As you, Father, are in me, and I am in you, may they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. The glory that you have given me, I have given them, so that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, that they may become completely one, so that the world may know that you have sent me and have loved me even as you have loved me. Father, I desire that those also whom you have given me may be with me where I am, to see my glory, which you have given me because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world does not know you, but I know you, and these know that you have sent me. I made your name known to them, and I will make it known so that the love with which you have loved me may be in them, and I in them.
This is always the time of year that's sort of bittersweet for me. We sort of not a goodbye, but sort of a well-wishing as our young people move on from our youth ministry and move into college and things beyond their youthful years. And I want to thank the choir. That was a beautiful, beautiful anthem, and I think it was very appropriate today. That I feel like you all are the salt of the earth and the light of the world, and we hope you will shine, and just the love that you all have given me and that we feel for each other, I hope that continues on in your lives as you move on into your college lives. So I want to just introduce everyone. We have Michael Spencer. You can stand up. Yeah. Francesca Bruni. And, of course, Samuel Kernahan. It's Kernahan, not Kenahan, as it is in the thing. We had a little typo there. Although it sounds a little more Irish that way. Kenohan, you know. And Kaylee Valeri. And they're going to share some reflections of their time in the church and their lives, and I have no idea what they're going to say. So it could be really fun. I think it's going to be. So anyway, I think, Samuel, I think you're going to start first.
All right. Is that David Muffet? Oh, no, yeah. Great guy. So... Hey, I'm Sam Kernahan, you probably know. Yeah, not Kenahan. I've grown up in this church, so it's a long time. It's all I've really known as a church, and I'm really glad that this is my standard for a church. It's taught me a lot of great things, from being young, showing me what a good handshake feels like, and also just... seeing a bunch of grown people and showing, like, caring for a kid and not teaching them, not treating them like a kid. And I feel like it's really helped me grow to be the person that I am. Yeah. I'm sorry. This is a little weird for me. I've always seen the seniors graduate and then standing up here and looking out and be like, wait, this is me. But I'm really thankful for this church. It's beautiful. Lots of good memories. Montreat, David. Even though the youth group may not always be large in numbers, it's always made up for that in quality people, except maybe Michael Spencer. Also, I'm going to talk about this right now because I know that Michael's going to bring it up in his speech. Michael Spencer, previously at Montreat, has caught more fish than I have. But I'm going to make a statement right now that that will not be the case this year. And that come Montreat Sunday, I'll be the one with the big fish. But really, that's just one among the many great memories. Such as catching my hair on fire during the Christmas services multiple times. So good laughs. Yeah, I'm gonna miss being here, going off to college. But it's bittersweet. But also, I know it's not the last time I'm gonna be at this church. So just hold on to that. Makes it a little easier going. I want to thank everybody here for being a good example and helping me, help raise me, and just thanks.
Being far from your family is really hard. I've realized just how lucky I am to be here with my family, Diane and Herb Simmons. They're very special people, loving, kind, compassionate. They're just simply marvelous. And I'm so grateful that I got the opportunity to live with them and get to know them. Today is a wonderful day, and it just so happens to be Mother's Day. I'd like you to take a moment to reflect on the power of the word mother. Someone who is selfless, generous, and caring. I have been so lucky to have these people in my life.
And Aunt Di has been like a mother to me in every way. She has made me feel at home. And I've realized that a house is not a home, and neither is a place. It's the people. And I've never felt more welcome than I have here at this church. From the moment I arrived, I was welcomed with open arms. And that really meant a lot to me, especially because at that time I didn't know anybody. Having a constant in my life has been essential to me. I'm a firm believer in the Christian faith, but this has been really special. Youth group has been fun and enlightening. We've had the chance to discuss current events and our own perception and perspectives of the Bible. We've laughed and cried together. We've grown as a family, and I will always remember my Wednesday nights at Spencer's, the church lock-in, the winter retreat, and all the various activities we do on Sunday nights. I'd like to thank David for being so patient with us. I know that sometimes we must have driven him mad. I'd like to thank the entire Kernahan family for being so helpful. Sam has always been there for me, and Stuart has always managed to make me laugh, and he reminds me so much of my little brother, Raffaele. Michael made sure I didn't feel left out in the beginning, and his humor has always been welcoming. Kaylee, with her spontaneity, is always a pleasure, and her great voice, of course. And Abby is always fun to hang out with. But she's also an amazing person and a great person to have a serious conversation with. A shout out goes to Mr. and Mrs. Covington, because everybody loves them. And a special thank you goes to my loving parents who have made it possible for me to be here today. And I know they would have loved to be here. And to my grandmother as well, Alice Bivin. After all, this is the church where my mom grew up. Bowling Green's Presbyterian Church will forever have a special place in my heart. So thank you to all who have made the dream come true.
So my reflection will be completely impromptu, as I am well known for around here. It all started when Samuel forgot to invite me to his birthday party. It was eighth grade, and he felt bad, so he invited me to laser tag in Nashville with his youth group. And 4 years, one emo phase, two trips to Montreat, and several hair colors later, I'm still here for some reason. It's my philosophy that you should definitely have two things in your life that you should fall back on. For me, those two things are music and this youth group, because there aren't a lot of things in my life that remain constant, but I already know, I mean, I always know that I can always make music, and I can always have these people to talk to when I do fall on hard times. It is sad that I am leaving, but I know that I can always visit, and I know that they'll still be here for me. And I've had so many great memories with these people. I don't think I've had one bad memory. And I'm so blessed to have been invited by Sam in eighth grade. Because this really has made such a difference in my life. It makes me want to go to church. It really shows me how good Christian people can be, and that there is good in this world despite all the bad news that we see on headlines every day. So thank you all so much, and I hope to make more memories this summer at Montreat.
Hello, I'm Michael Spencer. You might recognize me from the stewardship film we made a couple years ago. All right. So I'd like to take this moment to announce my retirement from the Bowling Green Presbyterian Youth Group. And I'd like to highlight some of the high points of my career. Well, for one, I'm the 5-year fishing champion at Montreat. And I've also been the first up the mountain every year. And Stuart thinks he's going to get me this year, but I don't think so. And so for a more serious note, I was an elder here at this church, and it's taught me a lot. And thank the church community for helping me through these 4 years of high school. That's the speech.
Thank you all. Well done. One other person I'd like to recognize today is Abby Potter. Abby's been our college intern for this semester and then last semester, and she's just been an amazing part of our group. She is stepping down as our college intern after this semester. She's got a big load next semester, and she's going to be working at Camp Lucon this summer. She is going to Montreat with us, though, so that's cool. But I want to thank Abby. You know, when you have interns or younger people, they're supposed to learn from you. And I think she's taught me more than I've taught her. She's just a blessing. And I just want you to know that we love you very much. And I really wish you would just stay with us. But we understand how you move forward. But I think Abby wants to say a few words herself. And I also have a Bible dictionary for you, too. So anyways, come on up.
Hi, I'm Abby. So thanks, David. And like David said, I'm not going to be the college intern here, so I'm not going to be actually working here after this semester. But although I will be gone at Camp Lucon this summer, so you won't see me during the summer, don't worry, because I will be back next semester just as a normal church member, and I will probably still come to youth group as much as I can. So I just want to say thank you to this church for being really great and surprising me with how welcoming you've been. I will keep this kind of short if I can, but I would like to say I had felt like a guest for a little while until Martha Haynes one Sunday turned around and said, "Hey, do you want to be lector next Sunday?" And I was like, "What's that?" Because if you don't know, I wasn't raised in the Presbyterian church, and so a lot of this has been really new to me. And she gave me that responsibility, but it wasn't like a chore. It was really neat for me to be able to partake here and to really feel like I'm able to contribute and give back to this community. So keep welcoming college students. Keep inviting them into your homes like you've invited me. Keep giving them responsibilities and making them feel part of this family. So I'm going to talk about seniors because I've been working a lot with the youth group, and they have a special place in my heart right now. And although I'm going to be kind of talking to you, I can't turn around. This is a little weird setup, but it's okay. Okay, so I am going to start with Francesca. So as you know, she's from Italy, and I just want to tell you a short story about the time I realized that she is a true Kentucky girl at heart. We were making brownies, and it was just not going well, let me tell you. We had put all the ingredients together, and we were mixing it, and we were like, what is wrong with it? It was horrible. It was just like, looked like clay dirt, you know, the really hard clay dirt, but like water on top of it. It wasn't mixing. It wasn't good. And we were just looking at it, like, so confused. Like, how did we create this monster? And then all of a sudden, Francesca goes, y'all, we forgot the eggs. And I was like, aw. Aw, she said y'all. So that was just a great memory with Francesca. But overall, she is the Instagram queen. If you don't follow her, I recommend it. She loves to explore. She is really great at understanding when people need things. Sometimes she would come up to me and be like, hey, is everything going okay? Like, you seem a little worried. And every time it's like, how did you know that? So she's really great at reading people and being kind and being able to fill those needs just right when she sees them. So I'm really glad you've been here, and I'm really sad you're going to be leaving. Love you. I'm just going in order on this sheet because I don't know how to go. I can't pick an order. So, Sam, hi. I've been teaching a lot of the youth group classes, and Sam has just been awesome. He is very wise, beyond his years, and it's really funny because, like, there's these two sides of Sam that work together just beautifully when it comes to youth group, because you have this part of Sam who's just, like, so smart, so wise, just, like, just gets it. And then you have the other side of Sam. And one of the great things about Sam is that he is confident enough in himself that he is not afraid to look so dumb in order to make other people laugh, which is a really great thing. In the best way. Sam has a spirit for pumping other people up like I've never seen. He can dance. He has got the moves. And I'm really going to miss him. Michael, this was interesting for me because when I was in high school, I was a real nerd. Not the kind of, like, cutesy, like, oh, I'm a nerd about this thing. I was the kind of nerd that, like, nerd is an insult in this case. I was a nerd. And I, for the longest time, thought Michael was not. And... And he was like an athlete. We were in high school together for a brief period, and I was like, oh, great. He's going to be in youth group, and he's going to be all like sports and whatever. But it's been awesome. And like from the beginning, I found out that Michael has a huge heart for everyone around him. He's a professional filmmaker. And... He is very compassionate and hilarious, and although he's really silly and is great at doing games, he also can talk about God and what his faith means to him in a real way. So I really appreciate that. While I'm working with the youth, it's great to have someone who is such a leader to be working with. So although I'm like teaching the lessons a lot of times, Michael is the one who can organize people and get people excited and start games and things like that, and in front of a crowd of witnesses, I'm going to say, if you don't work in youth ministry one day, I will be very sad. Also, I think his foot injury is a fake to get out of doing a photo shoot with me. Anyway, so Kaylee is my last senior on my list, and love you, Sam. If I had known I was going to do this speech sooner, I would have written it all in memes, and especially Here Come That Boy memes. Anyway, Kaylee is awesome, and even from, like, looking at her, you can tell she's a really interesting character and really fun to be around. She is always sporting her Heelys, always has bright colors and, like, fun makeup, and is just very excited about things. But that's just, like, one layer of why Kaylee is so great. She's also an excellent poet. She's really fantastic at putting into words emotions that not only she feels, but she can make her readers and listeners feel, which is a really cool power to have. It makes her a leader when it comes to understanding how people work. She can empathize and be brave enough to approach people and talk to them about how they're feeling, which is really important when it comes to working with other people. She can be fun and silly, but at the same time, she's very compassionate and brave, and I love you very much. I'm going to miss you. Also, I'm really glad she's going to be going to WKU. So, okay. Those weren't really pre-planned. They weren't best, you know. But I love these seniors very dearly, and even though I'm kind of new here, I just want to say thank you to the church for taking care of them for so long. And also, one last thing to all of you guys. I hope that one thing youth group has taught you is that if the four of you, who are very, very different people, can create a community about God and about faith and about how to take care of one another and bear each one another's burdens, I hope that you can go out into the rest of your lives and do that with people who may surprise you.
So very thankful to David for letting us include some college students in this year's graduation. It happens every once in a while that our college students graduate, and it's always bittersweet. We have two graduates this year, and this church does a marvelous thing for our college students in providing them scholarships to sing in the choir. Very often in the choir, we say we just can't survive without our college students. They help us out so much, but mostly we say we don't want to survive without them because we love them so much. They become part of our family. The choir embraces them. They embrace the choir and embrace this church. And we're happy for our two graduates this year. Ladies, come on down. Katie Morrison is a native of Bowling Green, and she's graduating with a degree in music education. Will be seeking a job in music education this fall. So if you have a school in your back pocket, hire her. And she's out student teaching now, doing a fine job. Abigail White has been with us the last 2 years and is going to pursue a degree in Masters of Vocal Performance at Loyola University in New Orleans, and she'll be leaving us in a couple weeks. We hope to keep Katie around for the summer. But two beautiful ladies inside and out, and congratulate them, too. And you'll get blessed by them in a few minutes in the service. But our appropriate gift to you guys is a leather-bound hymnal for our musicians. God bless you. Thank you.
join in the affirmation of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He descended into heaven. He sits on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Please be seated.
And let us all pray. Lord, we are glad to stop for a minute in the midst of this month of May, on Mother's Day, on graduation Sunday in our church, as the school year ends with exams and recitals and plans for the summer and some goodbyes. We're glad to pause here together for worship, which is plain and pure. By your presence, quiet our busy minds, calm our anxieties and fears, fortify our hope, and make us glad for all that's happening around us. We thank you today especially for mothers and for that special bond between mother and child. Thank you that our mothers care for us, and that is for us the first glimpse we have of being fed and loved and held and protected. Truly, it is from our mothers that we begin to learn about your care for your people. And truly, O God, we are your children. We also pray in thanksgiving for our graduates, for Samuel and Kaylee and Francesca and Michael, for Abby White and Katie Morrison. Let the way before them be cleared of any obstacle. Assure them that they are wonderfully and perfectly able, and let them make the best of those abilities. Reinforce their strengths and give them a readiness to learn and to be ready to do even more. Bless them to find ways to be of service to you. We also pray about the needs around us. Especially today, we pray for Martha Haynes, who is in such pain, and for Emily Perkins and David Wilkinson, and for Bill Beard and his family. Show your mercy to these people, we pray, and may that mercy be grandly expansive, so to gather all those who hurt or despair into it now and forever. We pray in expectation of the Pentecost celebration next Sunday. May the day of the Spirit's coming bring reinvigoration of our faith and commitment in this church. We need a new and fresh and refining day. And so add to our love of our church a deepened love for each other, that we may be joined in efforts that honor you and reflect the hope in Jesus Christ that we are blessed to share. Hear our prayers also for our nation. Correct in us all the ways we have not been one nation under God with liberty and justice. And teach us not to depend on elections to restore or improve us, but let our lives and our faith, the way in which we live, be our renewal. We pray for other nations of the world. We pray for ourselves. We pray for those seated with us on the right and on the left, so that no one will leave here today without having been prayed for. Each person around us has a story. Each of us has our own needs. We all want to open ourselves to your blessing and your healing. All of us have a burden or two, and we would like you to set these burdens aside. And so we ask your blessing for each other, and may that blessing be felt right now. as a deep breath of the peace that passes all understanding. And hear us as we join our hearts together in prayer, the prayer that you have taught us, and we say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. We are aware of special blessings today. Indeed, we are grateful for our seniors graduating. We're grateful for the beauty of worship and for the fellowship we enjoy with one another. The offering that we take is not a way of giving to God, but rather is a way of expressing our thanksgiving to God. And so, with great thanksgiving, let us come before God with our tithes and our offerings. God, thank you for all that you give us. Thank you for the passages in life. And today especially, we thank you for graduation. Because we love the people who are graduating, we are aware again of the way in which you enter into our lives and encourage us to take fresh and new steps. Help us to do that together and to do it in thanksgiving. We also offer this offering in an awareness that the future is yours and the strength of the church is yours and that these offerings are a part of that strength. And all this we pray in the strong name of our Lord Christ. Amen. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you, each one, and abide with you forever.